We're at Woodward Park for the 33rd annual CF State Cross Country Championships. It's going to be a cold one, it's going to be a fast one, and also it's going to be one where a lot of the best teams and individuals are thinking about, in the back of their minds, Nike Cross Nationals. That's next weekend in Portland, Oregon, and the top individual performers and team performers from tomorrow will be going on to Portland later on next week. What's it going to take? First off, let's look at the boys' side. On the boys' side, barring any disaster, there are two teams that are virtually a lock to make it to Nationals. Now, California gets two teams automatically, and it should be, in any particular order, Great Oak and Newbury Park. Those two teams have distanced themselves from the rest. If nothing major goes wrong there, then we're looking at teams battling it out for an at-large position. Will California get one, two, or none? Honestly, going into tomorrow, it can be any of the three. Any of the three more than ever before. And the reason being, California always thinks we're gonna get one, we're gonna get two. The best teams behind those top two have been very inconsistent this year. And I'm not saying that's gonna hurt them because so much waiting goes on the very last meet of the season. However, the big question is, which team is gonna show up? Of the teams that are in the hunt, like Dublin, like Bellarmine, there's a few others, a Claremont, for instance, a Thousand Oaks. There are several teams, I'm leaving a few of them out, there are several teams in the hunt on the boys' side. The question is, who is going to tomorrow duplicate their good day, and who is going to experience, as some of these teams have, another bad day? Because we've had some good teams that have not been clicking when it's really counted recently, and tomorrow's for all the marbles. Once all five races are done, we'll look at the results and we'll go from there. And then anybody that's not in the top two, which will probably be, once again, Great Oak and Newbury Park, then we have a committee conference call nationally to discuss who has the best resumes from the 18 teams that are in the pool nationally, the at-large pool. On the girls' side, it's not quite the same, but we do have two teams that have a bit of a cushion on the rest. Those two teams, one of them, once again, is Great Oak. The other one is Buchanan. Which one will win tomorrow? It is almost a coin flip. Buchanan has been coming along nicely this year, and Great Oak, they're very solid, and they've been adding some kids who've been hurt, but they're also sick. So the door's wide open. But those two teams have been, so far, the two best teams. Again, that's out the window, because more than anything, it's the last meet that matters. Not what happened at Woodbridge, not at Mount Sac, not at Clovis. It's postseason. This is what it's going to be about as far as who goes on to Nationals. As far as at large, pretty much similar to the boys in the fact that the contenders are going to be from Division II and from Division I. And there's a lot of teams there that are more consistent than the boys have. And will California get at-large teams there? It looks a little bit of a better chance than on the boys. There is some really good competition out there. We've got Division II, where I mentioned in another interview, we've got so many good girls teams in Division II that rank among the top 35, 40 teams in the country legitimately. So they're going to push each other to excellent times. So it should be great. And as far as individually, California individually is really good on the girls' side. On the boys' side, we're very strong, but several of the top kids are also on teams that project to qualify to NXN. So in that case, once you get the team qualifiers, the five fastest individuals in each gender will be invited also to Portland. And this year, so far, we won't know for sure till tomorrow, because tomorrow there are four qualifiers. There's California, there's a Southeast region, the Northeast region, and the New York region. But I can tell you right now, looking at the entry list and who we think we'll get tomorrow, this should be the best field of individuals we have ever had for both the boys and for the girls at Nike Cross Nationals in Portland, Oregon on Saturday, December the 7th. From Woodward Park in Fresno, where it's getting quite cold, Rich Gonzalez, Prep Caltrack.